college readiness.
Supportive.
Family.
Relief.
Leadership.
Stress-free.
Motivated.
Avid is fun.
Salty.
Fat.
Preparation.
Determination.
Family.
Encouragement.
Influential.
Guidance.
Success.
Useful.
A rack of prime ribs.
Family.
Is there any formula for this problem?
I know that the formula for the standard deviation, you just have to do the square root of the variance, but I don't know like how to get the variance.
Well, you're trying to find the variance of all the values. Well, you said you had to square it, right?
Yes.
So you know that,
Thank you.
San Diego State, Chico State, Sacramento State, and San Francisco State.
Where did you get accepted?
I got accepted to every one of those except San Diego State.
What is your best Avid memory or funniest moment?
Best Avid memory. Probably when I rapped in front of the class. It's cool because everyone thought it was funny.
Let me tell you about a college called San Diego State, in a beautiful city with many girls you can date. If you wanna get in, do about A to G. And all your grades should be higher than a C, but you can't mess around cause it ain't for free. So you better do your best on your SAT, and don't forget about your ACT. Wanna do good? Just listen to me. Now the cost per year depends what you get paid, so if I were you, apply for financial aid and need some money to pay the fee, but it's just too bad they don't offer woo-wee. Now I'm in the football and I like Aaron Rodgers. Bad San Diego is home to the Chargers, and if you don't believe me, I'm Google and check, but this is why I wanna be a San Diego Aztec.
What has Avid helped you with the most?
Avid has helped me with a lot of things actually, but probably the most would be it provides like a free study class. So if I have a test coming up, like use Avid to help me study for a test.
What is the biggest obstacle you've overcome?
And the biggest obstacle I ever came was coming to this new country and adapting and learning the language. It was a very hard thing for me to do. And just making new friends and trying to figure out how to be,
So Brandon, tell me, what advice do you wish that upperclassmen would have given you when you were a freshman?
To finish my A through G requirements early so I wouldn't have to take like a 1 through 6 my senior year, because that's what I'm taking right now, because I have to take drawing, and to just stay on top of all my homework and get good grades.
Excellent. So, Marissa, what do you think Avid's helped you with the most?
Well, I would say it's helped me a lot my senior year because we had a lot of time in the lab to do college applications and to sign up for scholarships and just to be on top of everything. Carly, what would you say your biggest regret was in high school?
Honestly, not taking a fine art sooner as a senior, being in a last period class.
If you had the choice to do Avid, would you choose to do it again?
Yeah, I would, because it's been really helpful to me. I've only taken it for 2 years, but I wish I would have taken more. If it wasn't for Avid, I probably wouldn't know like when to sign up for the PSAT, the SAT, and when like college apps are due and all that kind of stuff.
What is your best or funniest memory in Avid?
I have to say my best memory was when Zach, Brandon, and Dylan got in a foot race and Zach beat him.
That's not true. Here's a video.
I just showed them. What?
How long have you been an Avid?
3 years.
Where did you think you were going to college sophomore year versus now?
I probably thought of two places. I really wanted to go to either Stanford or UC Davis, and now I'm going to UC Davis, so yeah.
If you had the choice to take Avid, would you take it again?
Definitely. Definitely would take Avid again.
Well, you already answered. Where did you get accepted?
I got accepted to Cal Poly. I got on the waiting list for Cal Poly, but I didn't appeal that because I didn't really want to go. UC Davis, Azusa, and Sonoma. That's all where I applied to.
What does Avid mean to you?
I think a lot of Avid means like two main things to me is gives me hope, and for the relief that will come later from all of my efforts. Like when we had guest speakers, I would feel kind of pumped up about my college career or whatever was going to happen on afterwards. And so I'd have a lot more energy to do what I needed to do now in order for that to happen. And then it also helped me in jumping through the hoops that I needed to jump through for college, because most colleges just expect you to know everything ever about how to get into college, and most of us don't know anything about it. And so they provided information for us so that we were able to actually go to college, like when to take the SATs, what we needed to do specifically for like signing up for college and paying for college and all the stuff like that.
Yeah. So Simran, where did you apply to college?
I applied to UC Santa Barbara, UC Davis, and UC Irvine.
Where'd you get accepted?
Santa Barbara and Irvine.
That's good. What was your funniest moment in all your time at it?
I think one day we were playing dodgeball and Carly just fell. I don't even know why, like nobody threw a ball or anything, but it was pretty funny.
During your time in Avid, what do you consider your most influential moment?
The most influential moment was probably when we had a guest speaker come in, and you know, they really told us about their like experiences and like how college was, and that really like pushed me to go to college and get where I am today.
Good. And you had to have a regret sometime in there. Like what was your regret? What's your biggest regret?
My biggest regret was not taking Avid earlier, because it's just been so much help. And I took it my junior year, but I realized I should have taken it freshman year as well. Okay, so Mallory, where did you apply to college?
I applied to UNR, Cal Poly, Chico, Sonoma, and Sac.
And where did you get accepted?
I got accepted everywhere except Cal Poly.
So where are you going?
I'm going to UNR.
All right, and what are you going to be studying?
I'm studying kinesiology.
All right, so throughout your years in Avid, do you have any like funny memory or moment that stands out?
I think the other day when our whole class was playing kickball and Amar kept diving after the ball. Okay.
So how long have you been in Avid?
I've been in Avid for 4 years, since freshman year.
If you had the choice to do Avid again, would you?
Yes, I would, because it has helped me to get to where I'm at right now and to attend the school of my dreams.
You can sound the alarm, you can call out your cars, you can fence in your yard, you can pull out the cars, but I won't back down.
My topic is football. I play football. A lot of the guys do play football. I watch football. I'm a Patriots fan. I think they're the best team. Some people might disagree, like Niner fans, Charger fans. They probably shouldn't. They got kind of handled by the Dolphins. let's see. The Colts play today. And Colts are a nice team. We smacked them in the playoffs last year, no big deal. Niners, they lost to the Rams, kind of embarrassing. Raiders are don't have a win.
That was the
good job. Very good.
But I like going to the mountains as well, because I'm like no one's there and I can just like meditate or do random stuff or like kill wildebeest. I don't know. It's pretty great. But,
meditate or kill wildebeest.
Yeah, and then you can do anything you want because no one's around to see you. I mean, the beach, everyone's just like half naked and look at you like, all right. But I mean, the water is just amazing. I think it's nice to like sit on a beach and just look at the water and just see how like endless it looks, even though like that's not that big compared to the universe. And to think that the universe is so much bigger than that, just like gets everything else going and just reminds you. It's just the universe. I wasn't physics. It was science and something.
I got favorite singer.
Wow.
Shut up.
Oh. I don't really have a favorite singer, but I do like singing kinda.
Oh.
So.
Go ahead, David.
Sing in the shower. I love singing in the shower. And I'm pretty terrible though. Like, I literally have no range at all. I'm the same tone the entire time. Feel kind of bad for my neighbors, but.
Give us a sample. Yeah.
Like in Mr. Miller's class, the Pokemon song.
That was really bad.
Oh,
man.
Try again. We're not going to judge.
Okay, that's
all right.
Go ahead.
I forgot
how the Pokemon song goes. It's like, I want to be the very best, like no one ever was.
Settle down, Brandon's going.
So I got Mr. Bugs. So, if you don't know, that's Mr. Bogowski. Let's see, what do I have to say about Mr. Bogowski? Nothing really. He's really tall. He used to wear braces. He looks better without braces, by far. He comes in here a lot, often. I saw him this morning. In AP Gov. I don't know why he was there, he was kind of standing. He was like in my way, I was trying to get to my seat. And I was like, he was standing right there, and I was just trying to get to my seat, and I was like, move, please. I mean, I didn't say that, I was kind of standing there. I ended up going all the way around and getting to my seat. Yeah, it was a bit of a, okay.
So, my favorite sport is probably Wii Sports. It's cool. Like, tennis is probably the funnest one. Then, like, bowling, like, you just do, like, sitting down.
What's the point?
You know, like, I've done it before, like, while laying down. I was just like,
that's
like,
so
going like this. Like, golf is really boring and frustrating because you gotta, like, line it up and stuff. And
it's a stand up for that.
Yeah.